Please note that this video was made solely for demonstration purposes. Do not attempt to repeat the experiments shown in this video. Hello everyone! Today we will conduct various reactions with the metallic sodium. I finally managed to buy it, so I expect this video to be quite interesting. As you can see, sodium is stored in kerosene in such jar. We need to take a piece of sodium and put it on a filter paper to soak the remaining kerosene. First, I'll tell you about the physical properties of sodium metal. Density of sodium is almost the same as water, melting point being 97 degrees Celsius. Sodium is a quite soft metal and can be easily cut with a knife. Hardness of sodium is almost identical to an eraser that you use in schools. It requires the same effort to cut it. On the cut edge, you can see the shiny surface of sodium. However, being in the air, it oxidizes very quickly and coats with a layer of peroxides and carbonates. Now let's talk about the most interesting moment, the chemical properties of sodium. Sodium reacts with water. Take a small piece of sodium and put it in water. By the way, the indicator phenolphthalein was added in the water. As a result of reaction of sodium with water, sodium hydroxide and hydrogen are formed. From the heat of the reaction, the sodium melts and turns into a sphere. It is mostly safe to conduct experiments with small pieces of sodium, as they are the most controllable. Whereas large pieces of sodium ignite spontaneously and explode when reacting with water, so that is very dangerous. Now, let's see the reaction of sodium with ethanol. Put a piece of sodium in ethanol. As you can see, the reaction is quite slow. Moving to the next reaction, the interaction of sodium with hot glycerol. It is poured into the beaker, and let's add there a piece of sodium metal. Sodium immediately melts and lights up in our hot glycerol. This produces hydrogen and sodium glycerate. Next, let's view the reaction of sodium with 30% acetic acid. First, sodium lights up, and then the reaction proceeds the same way as it does with water. Now moving to the reaction of sodium with 30% hydrogen peroxide. This reaction again is very dangerous because sodium ignites and explodes. Next, the reaction of sodium and sulfur. I have poured a little bit of sulfur on the stove, and now I'm adding the pieces of sodium. To start the reaction, you must moisten the sodium. For this, I have used a wet piece of stick. As well to all that, I quite like the behavior of sodium on the wet grass. If you put sodium on the wet grass, it ignites and starts to burn. The product of this reaction is sodium peroxide. Finally, I just couldn't resist and decided to throw approximately 15 grams of sodium in a large puddle. Don't repeat that experiment by yourself, because it's very dangerous.
Это все? Какой-то китайский, наверное. Ой. Ты кайфуешь?
Это все? Нет. Какой-то китайский.
Насос! Чё за хуйня? Блядь!